Hello, scientists. Caroline here. In our last lesson, we learned that DNA is the blueprint of life. It exists in all living things, providing the instructions that cells need to grow and thrive. Just as computer code directs how software operates, DNA contains the information necessary for the development and maintenance of an organism. Scientists study DNA to better understand how organisms function and how living things might be connected. But how do scientists actually get DNA out of cells so that they can study it? And once they get it out, how do they separate it from all of the other cellular stuff? You might think it's a super complicated high-tech process, right? Well, what if I told you that you can extract DNA right at home using simple ingredients from your kitchen? I'll show you step-by-step how this process works, and by the end, you'll have an up-close look at your very own DNA. To the lab! Today, we'll be completing a DNA extraction lab. In this video, I'll walk you through all of the steps as I complete the lab. Before you continue with this video and lab activity, pause here to read over the safety information, materials, and lab procedure in your lesson materials with a parent or guardian. Double check that you have all of the materials out and ready, and that you have safety goggles to wear during the experiment. Because this lab requires special safety precautions, you must have parent or guardian supervision to participate in the lab. If you do not have parent or guardian supervision, you should not attempt to perform any of the lab activities. Once you have your grown-up's permission, you can use your own materials at home to follow along with me and extract your own DNA. As we work through the lab, feel free to pause the video if you need more time to complete a step, or to rewind the video if you need to see one of the steps again. If you're unable to complete the lab at home, no problem. You can watch this video and record your observations using my DNA instead of your own. Are you ready, scientists? Let's get started. You should have already read through the lab procedure and collected the necessary materials. So let's take a moment to get all of these materials organized and ready. I'm going to put on my safety goggles before we begin. It's very important to put on your goggles before you handle any of the lab materials and have them on for the entire lab activity. Our first material is isopropyl alcohol. You'll want to double check the percentage on the label. It should be at least 70%. Higher is even better. I have 91%. Our alcohol also needs to be chilled in the freezer for at least 2 hours before we start our experiment. If your alcohol has not been chilled in the freezer, the experiment may not work. You'll want to stop here to put the alcohol in the freezer and come back in a couple of hours to start the experiment. Next, we'll need a 250 or 500 milliliter beaker. If you don't have these, you can easily use a liquid measuring cup. We'll also need a half tablespoon. We'll also need a way to carefully move a very small amount of liquid. Scientists use a pipette, but you can also use an eyedropper or a baby's bottle. Lastly, make sure you have your dish or hand soap, salt, a regular kitchen or plastic spoon, a toothpick, and a clear cup of any size. You'll also need water. I have regular water in this pitcher, but you can also just get your water from the sink. These materials are going to let us isolate and see the DNA from our cells. Based on what you know about DNA, what do you think the extracted DNA will look like? Use words and drawings to record your hypothesis in your lab notes. Now that we have all of our materials and our hypothesis, we are ready to begin our experiment. I'll be using my lab equipment, but keep an eye out for alternative lab materials you can use as you follow along. The first step in our procedure is to measure 250 milliliters of water in a beaker or 1 cup of water in a liquid measuring cup. Next, we are going to add our salt to the water. Measure 1/2 tablespoon of salt and add it to the beaker or measuring cup of water. Once the salt is added, use the regular spoon to stir your mixture until all of the salt is completely dissolved. This might take a minute. We now need to get a sample of our DNA. The cheek cells on the inside of our mouth are relatively easy to get to. This is why doctors can take cheek swabs for cultures. Before you put anything in your mouth, please pay attention as I go over all of the directions. In a moment, you are going to collect your cheek cells by carefully swishing a small amount of the saltwater solution in your mouth for 30 seconds. As you swish, use your tongue to scrape the inside of your cheeks. Be very careful not to swallow any of the salt water. Once you have done this for at least 30 seconds, spit the solution into the clear cup. You can watch me complete this step first, then pause the video to do it yourself. Now it's your turn. Now that some of your cells are floating around the salt solution, the next step is getting the DNA out of each cell. Remember how cell membranes are a lipid bilayer? Well, we can use soap to break down that membrane, just like it's used to break down fats and oils when cleaning dishes in the sink. Next, we'll add 2 small drops of soap to the clear cup containing the solution of salt water and cheek cells. Then gently, to avoid creating suds, we'll stir the soap into the solution for 20 seconds. Now that the soap has broken down the lipid bilayer of the cell membrane, DNA is floating around in this solution inside the cup. The salt in the solution helps the DNA strands to clump together, but since DNA is microscopic, it's difficult to see. When we add isopropyl alcohol, a chemical reaction causes the DNA to clump even more. Since alcohol is less dense than the saltwater solution, it flows to the top, bringing the DNA with it. This allows us to see the DNA. First, we need to add chilled alcohol to the pipette or eyedropper. If you are using a baby bottle instead, you only need to add a small amount of chilled alcohol. Next, we are going to tilt the cup to a 45 degree angle. Then using the pipette, eyedropper, or baby bottle, slowly add 20 drops of the chilled alcohol down the inner side of the cup. The more slowly you can do this step, the better your results will be. When you're finished, carefully tip your cup back to normal and set it gently on the table. Be sure to move slowly. If the solution inside the cup sloshes around, it could mix the DNA you just separated back into the solution. Allow your cup to rest on the table for 5 minutes. While you wait, don't touch the cup or the solution. Touching the cup or solution while you wait could prevent the DNA from separating out from the rest of the solution. Pause here to set a timer and wait for 5 minutes. At this point, you can hopefully see a layer of a cloudy substance in the cup. That cloudy layer is DNA. At the top of my cup, there's a clump of genetic material. It looks bubbly, cloudy, and stringy to me. What does yours look like? Pause the video here to draw and describe what your cup looks like in your interactive lab notes. We can make the DNA more visible by helping it clump together even more. The trick here is not to mix, but twirl the DNA up, like you might with spaghetti noodles on a fork. I'm going to use a toothpick, but if you don't have one, you could use a skewer or plastic fork or knife instead. With the toothpick held straight up in the DNA solution, slowly swirl the stick through the solution. Pause the video, give it a try, and use words and drawings to record your observations in your lab notes. If your DNA looks a little different than mine, or if you don't see any DNA, that's okay. In an experiment, there are many variables that can affect the results. If you don't have visible DNA, try the steps again now that you are more familiar with them. Usually, no visible DNA means the alcohol was not cold enough, or when you poured in the alcohol, it didn't stay in a layer on top of the solution. If you can't repeat the experiment, you can rewind the video and make observations of my DNA to draw your own conclusions. Analyzing evidence to draw conclusions is an important part of the scientific method. At the beginning of the lab, you made a hypothesis about what the extracted DNA would look like. Look back at your prediction now. Does the extracted DNA look like you expected it to? Take a moment to pause here and record your thoughts in your lab notes. You might have predicted that the DNA would look like a double helix. So why did it look all stringy instead? The DNA inside your cells does form this spiral staircase shape, but to see the molecular double helix structure, we would need to look at the DNA we collected under a powerful microscope. In fact, if DNA is microscopic, how do we see it at all? Let's use a rope as an example. A person can't see a single cotton thread from far away, but if you wound 1,000 cotton threads together into a rope, it would be much more visible. How does this comparison relate to the DNA we extracted in the lab? Every cell in your body, with a few exceptions, contains all of the DNA that codes your unique traits. In this lab, we took lots of these cells from our cheek, opened those cells up, and separated the DNA from the rest of the material. Because we took DNA from so many cells and dumped it all together, we can see it. This simple experiment shows us how scientists can extract and study DNA, the molecule that holds all the instructions for life. As exciting as it is to extract DNA in your own home, this technique is also important in scientific research. Why do you think scientists might need to extract DNA? Pause the video here to brainstorm a few ideas and record them in your lab notes. Isolating DNA is important for medical research and developing treatments to genetic diseases. Solving crimes by comparing DNA samples. Improving crops and agriculture. Studying the biodiversity of ecosystems in environmental science. And tracing family ancestry and history. Understanding the structure of DNA is the first step to understanding how this powerful molecule holds the key to all of the variety we see in living things, from tiny bacteria to giant redwood trees and everything in between, including you. As we went through the lesson today, you got a chance to sharpen your experimental science skills by isolating DNA molecules from your own body. Along the way, you hopefully considered all the ways that our bodies depend on DNA. Our cells would have no way of knowing what to do without it. If you struggled to get the results you were expecting from the experiment, feel free to try again. Science is often a matter of trial and error, and even professional scientists sometimes have to try an experiment many times before they perfect the procedure. I'm Caroline, and remember, life is full of wonders, so keep learning and don't ever stop wondering. Hey, hey.